إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. We continue today. We'll keep the class short, inshallah ta'ala. For real this time. Whenever I say that, it's like a community joke. But inshallah, we'll keep it short. And one of the reasons for that is that we want to try to finish this book. There's not much left of it. We don't want to miss weeks. And by the time changes, here in about a month or so, we want to begin the book, probably Al-Aqidatul Wasitiyah by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, twice a week. So we're going to rearrange some things in the schedule, and hopefully bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, as the warm weather approaches, take a topic and a subject matter that will be more comprehensive and important for the community. And this book is a book in Aqidah, as we have seen. It's also a book on good character, and it's the section that we're on right now is about good character. And we find that many of the scholars of Islam, that in their books on Aqidah, such as Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, that at the end of those books they have a section about good character. We find, for example, Ibn Battah al-Ukbari rahimahullah ta'ala, at the end of Al-Ibanatul As-Sughra, which is not really the name of the book, but it's called Al-Ibanatul Sughra, and Yasharhu Al-Ibana an Usul Al-Diyana, or something of the sort, that he has also a section on good character. And there are a number of the scholars that have likewise in their writings, Abu Shaykh Al-Asbahani, and in the book Al-Mahajjah fi Bayan, Al-Hujjah fi Bayan Al-Mahajjah, and others. At the ends of their books of Aqidah, they have a section on manners and character and so on and so forth. And that is because of the thamara and the natija, the fruit and the result of having a good correct belief, is that it affects and impacts a person's behavior and how they speak and how they act and so on and so forth. And so I don't want to inconvenience anybody, but if I have vision problems, so if people can move a little closer and not be so scattered out. Barakallahu feekum. So we mentioned last week a number of things. We mentioned the importance of, when we talk about this affair of the thamara, of the fruit and character of good creed, then first and foremost, that it causes a person to be sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now you guys are a little too close to me, so I feel like I owe you money or something. Adakulin. Thirdly, after a person's belief system causing him to be more sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and along with that, he mentioned being less showy, that a person doesn't do what they do to be seen or heard of other people, that they take the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as their role model that they pattern themselves after, and in that is following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the two conditions for the acceptability of any deed that a person does to be classified and any genuinely be termed and called worship, has to be done with sincerity according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He mentioned the third thing, therefore, after a person and he has these two things that are the prerequisites of worship, that along with worship, as we say in the Fatiha, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. So he mentioned the third thing, which is a tawakkul, any reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we mentioned that this concept of a tawakkul ala Allahi tabarak wa ta'ala, and of having reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said in his book Madarij As-Salikin, that this concept of having reliance and trust and dependency upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it is the fruit, it is the result of knowing about all of Allah's beautiful names and all of His lofty attributes. So the fruit and the benefit of knowing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having a correct creed regarding the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that it causes a person to put their dependency and their reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where is Sahibul Bid'ah, the person of innovation, who, for example, like the Asha'ira, May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala guide them, and they are many from the Muslims, and they deny al-ilal. They deny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does things for wisdoms, and they say ridiculous things like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of anything. And so if we say that Allah does things for a reason, that means that He needs to have reasons. And so Allah does things without purpose at the end of the day is what they're saying. And this is such a ridiculous statement that many of our scholars have pointed out that in those societies where these beliefs are institutionally spread and taught in the school systems and so on and so forth, that correlating with this rise of these deviant teachings, you find the rise of suicide. You find the rise of suicide. And because if a person doesn't believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regarding what He does and decrees to happen in the life of a person, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is not doing that out of mercy and out of justice and out of raising the person and so on and so forth. And He, as is found in the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then a person becomes hopeless. A person becomes hopeless, and their reliance is not upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala haqqan, and in reality. And so these affairs, as we listen to them, they are all, the point here is that they are all of these things that we are going to hear inshallah ta'ala over the next few weeks, that they are all connected to a person's belief system. They're all connected to a person's belief system. And that is the case with this next issue that we are going to cover briefly today, the issue of al-sabr, the issue of al-sabr. The issue of patience in Islam is of the utmost importance. And to the point that the scholars of Islam, they say that manzilatu al-sabri min ad-din ka manzilatu ra'si min al-jasad. Meaning that the station and the position of sabr in connection to the rest of the religion is like the position of the head to the rest of the body. Without patience, a person is going to leave his religion, or is very likely to leave his religion. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ. And from the people are those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as though they are upon the edge, like the edge of a cliff. And أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ أَطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ. And if good happens to the person, then they feel at peace. And if fitna happens, the person, he turns back on his face, and he loses out in this world and the hereafter. These verses, At-Tabari rahimahullah ta'ala in his tafsir, he mentions that these verses, they revealed about some people from the Bedouins that had embraced Islam, they had accepted Islam, and they came to Al-Madinah. And just like anybody, when they move from one location and one environment and climate to another climate and environment, as happened to the Prophet ﷺ and his companions, when they move from Mecca to Medina, you're going to get sick. A person just traveling for a short-term travel, if you go from one place to another, the water in that land, the food in that land, is not what your norm is, not the norm is not what you're used to. You're going to get sick. And so these people, they moved from the Bedouin lands and from where their tribes were located and so on and so forth. Then they moved to the city of Al-Madinah, and many of them became very ill, and many of them, just like the Prophet ﷺ, had a very difficult time, or the companions rather, the Prophet ﷺ had a very difficult time once they arrived in Al-Madinah, going from a mercantile society that was in Mecca, where people made their money by business and trade, to going to an agricultural or farming society, which was where most of the money in Al-Madinah came from farming and growing dates and grapes and these sorts of things, that it was very difficult for them to make money, and they got very sick upon arriving. The same thing happened to these Bedouins. And they said that Islam is bad luck. This is what they said, that Islam is bad luck, and they started to be tested by Allah. After accepting Islam, and the smallest test caused them to apostate from Islam. They saw that they became Muslims, and their life became difficult and hard and so on and so forth. And instead of being patient and seeking the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, caused them to have bad thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and bad thoughts about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the religion, to the point that they left Islam because they lacked patience. So patience to the religion is like the head on the body. A head without a body cannot live, and the religion without patience is not going to survive within a person's heart. And so Shaykh As-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he continues, he said, تَصَبَّرْ عَنِ الْعِسْيَانِ وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِهِ. Be patient in abstaining from disobedience. وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِهِ. And be patient with the hukum of Allah. The hukum of Allah here, the ruling of Allah, the judgment of Allah, meaning the qadr, meaning what is difficult that happens in the life of a person, of sickness and poverty and these sorts of things, or the harms of another person. Allah tests you at the hands of another human being and these sorts of things. Whatever is difficult and hard from the qadr, from what Allah has predestined to happen in a person's life. This is mandatory that a person is patient. It's mandatory that a person is patient, and it is recommended that a person is pleased. Those are two different things. Being patient is habsu nafs an tasakhut, is that a person fights against their self and they stop themselves from being displeased. To stop yourself from being displeased is not exactly, of course, the same thing as being pleased. It's not the same thing as being pleased. What is mandatory regarding what is difficult from the qadr of Allah is that a person is patient with what is difficult from the qadr of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And so he mentions two so far out of the three categories of patience. Patience in Islam goes back to these three categories that we are going to hear. تَصَبَرْ عَنِ الْعِسْيَانِ وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِهِ وَصَابِرْ عَنِ الطَّاعَاتِ عَلَّكَ تَسْعَدُ عَلَّكَ أي لَعَلَّكَ تَسْعَدُ مُرَاعَةً الْوَزْنِ الشِّعْرِ تَصَبَرْ عَنِ الْعِسْيَانِ وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِهِ وَصَابِرْ. And be even more patient when it comes to being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that perhaps you may be of those that are successful and happy in both worlds. فِي هَذَا حَثٌ عَلَى الصَّبْرِ بِأَنْوَعِهِ الثَّلَاثَ. As Shaykh Abdul Razak al-Abad, he explains, he says that within this line of poetry, any of these verses of poetry, is an encouragement to be patient, and a mention of the three types of patience. إِذَا صَبْرُ بِاعْتِبَارِ مُتَعَلَّقِهِ ثَلَاثَةُ أَقْسَامٍ. And as much as that, patience connected to what you must be patient from, when we discuss what you must be patient concerning, is of three categories. And the statement that he mentions here is found in the tremendous book of Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala that is called عِدَّةُ صَابِرِينَ عِدَّةُ صَابِرِينَ وَالذَّخِيرَةُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. A book that is around 800 pages that is written about the virtues and the benefits of patience and gratitude. Patience and gratitude, they are the two halves of Islam, the two halves of Iman. Abdullah bin Mas'ud, he said, Al-Imanu Nisfan. Iman is two halves. There are two halves of Iman. One half of Iman is patience. One half of Iman is gratitude. So the entirety of a person's Islam is his reacting in a manner pleasing to Allah, to what is good from the decree of Allah, and what is difficult from the decree of Allah, what is easy from the decree of Allah, which he needs to show gratitude for, and what is difficult from the decree of Allah, which he needs to show patience concerning. He says, so there are three things that patience is connected to. صَبْرٌ عَلَى الْأَوَامِرِ وَالطَّاعَاتِ حَتَّى يُؤَدِّيَهَا وَصَبْرٌ عَنِ الْمَنَاهِ وَالْمُخَالَفَاتِ حَتَّى لَا يَقَعَ فِيهَا. First, a person is patient with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered, and in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until he carries out what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has obligated. Secondly, that a person is patient in staying away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden, and in staying away from those things that go against his religion so that he doesn't fall into them. وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى الْأَقْدَارِ وَالْأَقْضِيَةِ حَتَّى لَا يَتَسَخَّطَهَا. And thirdly, that a person is patient with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained and decreed to happen, has destined to happen in his life, so that he is not upset and angry pertaining what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed. So he says the first of these things, according to the arrangement, the order that was mentioned here by As-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, is to be patient in staying away from sin and disobedience. And this is that a person withholds from, that he fights himself. The word patience, it means habs, habsu nafs, yani to withhold yourself, to have self-restraint. That a person has self-restraint from committing sins. وَحَبْسُهَا وَحَبْسِهَا عَنِ الْوُقُوعِ فِي مَحَارِمِ اللَّهِ وَمُقَارَفَتِهَا. And that he withholds himself, that he has restraint pertaining what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden, and falling into those things. فَإِنَّهَا تَحْتَاجُ إِلَى صَبْرٍ لِيَمْتَنِعَ عَنِ الْمَعَاسِ. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, in the same book that the author or the explainer, Shaykh Abdul Razak al-Abad, had quoted that statement from, he has a section of 28 things, I believe, that a person, by understanding, that it will make it easy for them to stay away from sin and disobedience. And the explainer of this book is Shaykh Abdul Razak al-Abad. He explains all of those things and in a separate book that is translated into English. That is translated into English, and we encourage the brothers to look at the Salafi bookstores and to try to find this book. I forget exactly what they titled the book as, but the book is in Arabic, and it is something about mawani', the things, the motivations that cause a person to stay away from sin and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is a very enjoyable read. He said the person, he needs to be patient in order to prevent himself from disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who is not patient, تَفَلَّتَتْ نَفْسُهُ عِنْدَ أَدْنَ شَهْوَةٍ, when he is presented with the smallest impulse, the smallest desire, his self is going to get away from him. He's going to lose control of himself. فَمَا أَنْ يَدْعُوهُ الدَّاعِي وَتُنَادِيهِ الشَّهْوَةِ. And as soon as he is tempted, and as soon as he is summoned by his impulses and his lust, then he is going to fall into sin and disobedience. وَمَا أَكْثَرَهَا فِي زَمَانِنَا هَذَا. And how frequent does this occur, and how commonplace is this in the time in which we live, that people are tempted with the smallest things, and they don't find the self-control within themselves to stay away from what Allah تبارك وتعالى hates. إِنْ دَفَعَ وَرَاءَهَا وَانْسَاقَ وَهَذَا لَا يُوَفَّقَ بَيْنَمَا إِذَا كَانَ مُتَحَلِّيًا بِالصَّبْرِ وُفِّقَ لِلْإِمْتِنَاعِ عَنِ الْمَعَاصِي وَالْإِنْكِفَافِ عَنْ فِعْلِهَا. He said, this person doesn't have the ability to fight his temptation, so on and so forth. As soon as it comes to him, he's going to get carried away and pulled into sin and disobedience. And this person doesn't have the tawfiq from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, because he has not made the effort. He said, on the other hand, if a person had adorned himself and beautified himself with patience, then he will find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have guided him to staying away from sin and disobedience and withholding himself from falling into them. Fafil hadith, it comes in the authentic hadith that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهِ. That whoever يَتَصَبَّرْ أَيَتَكَلَّفْ الصَّبَرْ. Whoever forces himself to be patient, even if it's not natural, even if it is something that is not genuinely who he is, that he is a patient person, he forces himself to be patient, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him patient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him patient. Whoever forces himself to be patient, fights himself, gives, and he has some kulfa, and he some diligence in making himself patient, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him patient. Meaning, مَنْ تَصَبَّرَ مَرَّةً بَعْدَ مَرَّةٍ فَازَ بِالْعَاقِبَةِ الْحَمِيدَةِ. Meaning the person that time after time he forces himself to be patient, and he will find a praiseworthy outcome in his favor, that he will be guided to patience and to having a good reward from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The second of the three categories, وَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِهِ, and be patient with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has judged to happen. Meaning be patient with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed upon you, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained. Mean musabin or ibtila'in or nahwi dhalik, of calamity or hardship or the likes of that. As Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَالنَّقْصِ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَثَمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرَ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, and certainly without a doubt, Allah in his greatness will test all of you with something of fear, and some portion of hunger, and some portion of a loss of wealth, and life and property, the loss of loved ones, the loss of health, the loss of athamarat, yani the fruits of one's labor and the fruits of agriculture and so on and so forth. وَبَشِّرْ الصَّابِرِينَ, and give glad tidings and good news to those that are patient. الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ, they are those that when they are stricken with a calamity, they say, indeed we belong to Allah, and indeed we are returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, and so what is meant by al-hukum in these lines of poetry, the ruling of Allah in these lines of poetry, is al-hukmul kawniyul qadari. It's what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has judged and decree to happen in the life of a person connected to the qadr. لِأَنَّ الْحُكْمَ تَارَةً يُرَادُ بِهِ الْحُكْمُ الْكَوْنِيُّ الْقَدَرِيُّ وَتَارَةً يُرَادُ بِهِ الْحُكْمُ الشَّرْعِيُّ الدِّينِيُّ. He said, sometimes when we say hukm, what is meant is the qadr of Allah, and sometimes we say hukm, a ruling, what is meant is what Allah has ordered and forbidden in the religion. He said, which is to leave off disobedience and to do what Allah has ordered, which are the other two categories of patience. فَيَكُونُ مُرَادُهُ بِقَوْلِهِ وَاصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِهِ. And so this is what is meant by be patient with what Allah has judged, meaning with what Allah has decreed to happen in your life. The third and the final category of patience is to be patient in doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered you to do of obedience, meaning being force yourself to be patient upon obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Patience requires, or obedience rather requires, that a person is patient. That a person is patient so that he makes it a habit for him to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He said, فَعْبُدْهُ وَاصْطَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِهِ هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيًّا. He said tabaraka wa ta'ala, so worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient in that worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know of anything that is equal to Allah or equivalent to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? And so a person is to be patient, and from that, or he is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is to worship Allah patiently. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala likewise, He says, Ya ayyuha ladina amanu sbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu wa taqullaha la'allakum tuflihun. O you who believe, in the last verse of Surah Ali Imran, O you who believe, be patient. وَصَابِرُوا. The scholars, they say, and be more, what is meant here by وَصَابِرُوا means be more patient than your adversaries. Because the disbelievers and the people of falsehood, they are patient upon their falsehood. They are patient in spending their wealth in the path of shaitan. They are patient in fighting against the truth, so on and so forth. People diligently work for the hellfire. عَامِلَةٌ نَاصِبًا. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He mentions about the disbelievers that their faces, and on the day of judgment, that you see that they had strove, that they had made efforts in the life of this world, and that they had exhausted themselves in the path of falsehood. تَصْلَى نَارًا حَامِيًا. And he تَصْلَى نَارًا حَامِيًا. What comes as a result of that? Of their amal and their nusb, their nasab and their amal, their hard work and their diligence and their falsehood, that they will arrive in the fire of hell, blazing fire. نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ النَّارِ. So this is the reality of the affair. The person, the believer, he knows that whatever he goes through of difficulty, the fact and the reality of the matter is that no matter what the believer goes through of difficulty, that what the disbelievers are going through is much more difficult. It is much more difficult. No matter if a person has billions of dollars, no matter if a person has everything that a person could ever want in this world, his life is miserable if he doesn't have iman. His life is miserable if he doesn't have the Quran. His life is miserable if he doesn't have guidance. This is a statement that is mentioned throughout the writings of our scholars, particularly throughout the writings of Ibn Qayyim and Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, when they talk about al-ghuraba fi akhir al-zaman, the strangers at the end of time, that this is a principle that they must focus upon, that when Islam is strange and you are a minority amongst a disbelieving majority, that you must always remember that whatever you go through of hardship and difficulty, إِن تَكُونُوا تَأَلَمُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ يَأَلَمُونَ كَمَا تَأَلَمُونَ وَتَرْجُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَرْجُونَ. If you are suffering, then they suffer just like you suffer. The disbelievers suffer just like you suffer. There's no one in this world except that there is some type of suffering that they endure. وَتَرْجُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَرْجُونَ. But you have to hope for from Allah what they can never have to hope for. You have raja, you have a hope in the reward of Allah from ihtisab, from being patient and seeking the reward of Allah for your patience in a way that they can never have hope. And so you suffer, and as a result of your suffering, you increase in hope and the mercy and kindness of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, to the point that some of the scholars, they say, أَعَظَمُ الْعِبَادَاتِ إِنْتِذَارُ الْفَرَجْ عِنْدَ الشِّدَّةِ. And that the greatest act of ibadah, and it is mentioned as a hadith, but the hadith is da'if, but the meaning is authentic, that the greatest form of ibadah, the greatest form of worship, is waiting for relief during hardship. waiting for relief during hardship. Intidhar al-faraj inda shidda. When hardship comes at a person, waits for relief that he has good thoughts about Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. And so if this is a meaning that is agreed upon by the scholars, that the greatest act of worship is to have husnul dhan billah inda shada'id. When things are difficult, that a person has good hopes and thoughts about Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, then the opposite of that is also true, which is that su'ul dhan billah وَالْيَأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ وَالْقُنُوتِ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ الْكَبَائِرِ بَعْدَ الْإِشْرَاكِ بِاللَّهِ. After shirk with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the scholars, they say, based on the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a person having despair and losing hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it is the greatest of the major sins after shirk. And it is the most likely of the major sins that is less than shirk, that will cause a person, that may lead a person out of Islam. That a person despairs of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is an affair that is connected to aqidah. And aqidah, a person's creed and his belief, his iman billahi tabarak wa ta'ala, the first and most important result of it is that it causes him to have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, O you who believe, be patient and be more patient than your adversaries. وَالرَّابِطُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And stand on guard patiently, and he protecting the frontiers of Islam, and have taqwa of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So that you could be of those that are successful. As the author, he says, meaning the author of the poetry, he says at the end of this verse of poetry, عَلَّكَ تَسْعَدُ. If you do this, then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will, from His noble honoring and favoring of the believer, and He will honor you with success and happiness in this world and the hereafter. When a person combines between these three things, being patient and staying away from what Allah has forbidden, being patient pertaining the decree of Allah that is difficult in the life of a person, what Allah decrees and destines to happen in a person's life, and being patient and being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being consistent in His worship. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.